our economy, because clearly you find that we are having challenges. When you find Treasury putting austerity measures to ensure that the economy grows, it's just a clear indication that we have challenges. You look at, I mentioned a company like Munias, has they have sacked all their workers. Portland Cement also had a challenge of their workers. So the question we're asking ourselves is that, where are these people going? These are people who have been earning a living. Now they find themselves on the streets, and many, many more are going to follow if we are not here. And some of the bills that we have already passed as a Senate, which make business easier, and I've also mentioned them, for example, the Warehouse Receipt Act, the County Licensing Bill, the Local Content Bill, the Fiscal Planning Bill, the Energy Bill, the Petroleum Bill, the Copyright Amendment Bill, the Public-Private Partnership Amendment Bill, the Land Value Index Laws, the County Outdoor Advertising Control Bill, the Natural Resources Benefits Sharing Bill, and the County Tourism Bill. All these, some have originated from the National Assembly. They have come to Senate for concurrence. They are meant to create an enabling environment for business to thrive in our country. Imagine maybe 500 people who have been working, now they have no jobs. They are on the street. This is a recipe for chaos. This is a recipe for criminality, because the people will look for ways of survival. Because I'm sure in the next 2 months or 3 months in Mumias, people will start feeling the impact of these people who now have they have to take care of their families being jobless. People who are in Portland, are being jobless. Some of them might now be traveling back home. So we must really look for a way of addressing that and find a way of fixing it. Otherwise, it's a time bomb.
Devolution.
So I think we need to, like I said, we need a conversation. People have solutions. Just that we are not talking to each other. We need to talk to each other. We need to sit down and agree. This is our country. Everybody, nobody applied to be here. We were all born here, and by God's mercy. So we just need to come up with a solution. Like I said here, we now need to come up with concrete recommendations, not just talking. Concrete recommendations. What is it that we need to do as a country to make sure that business is thriving, to create more? How do we, for example, what are they called? Cottage industries, for example, in our counties. Are we able to create more cottage industries that we can absorb more people who are coming out of school? And it's going to be very, very challenging, because we are churning out very many graduates, some in very specialized courses like engineering. These are people who can come up with anything that can even be dangerous. And they also become vulnerable into being recruited into gangs, or recruited into organizations that can become dangerous. Because people, at the end of the day, somebody will have to survive. How does he survive? He has 10 children. He has been working. Now he has no job. How will the children feed? The children don't understand that they have been sacked. So how will he survive? Those are the questions that we must ask ourselves. And it can come to a time where those who don't have now invade those who have. It can get that bad, because it has happened elsewhere in the world. Nobody is going to be comfortable. You may think you are comfortable because you have it, but those who don't have it will just come and take whether you like it or not. And that is where it can get to.
Sometimes we talk about the economy doing so badly and never look at where it's doing well. And I think we shift that way as a country many times. And so we never address the issues. So I look at the economy like a forest. And so the forest can be burning on one end, but it can be green on another end. So can we ensure the green side is moving and that it's not touched by the fire as we address the fire? And that's what's really happening right now. So the narrative that everything is bad, I think is a wrong narrative. I think it's best to say, where is it burning? What do we need to do in the areas that it's burning? Mm-hmm. And then where is it working? What can we do? And why I say that, if you look at, there's no way if it was all burning, you'd have almost 200 Americans coming last week looking for investments in this country. You didn't be seeing organizations like Amazon Web Services looking to open Kenya East African offices next year in the country. You didn't be seeing companies like the pasta making company in Kilifi that is finally going to start operating soon if everything was burning. So we need to be careful to have the right narrative. You didn't be looking at companies like Bidco that promised to open 4 new factories this year, and they're almost opening the other factories they're going to open. They're going to be opening the next one next month in Nakuru, right here in Nakuru. So we need to be careful with the narrative we're using. Then go to the real challenges. Where are the real challenges? Jobs is affecting everyone in Africa. So what do you need to do? Then where else are we hurting? Corruption is a big thing. What do we need to do with that? So I'd love us to have at that kind of a holistic discussion than a segmented discussion.
Thank you.